Lingabe litshona njani Zimbabwe omuhle siyalamukela kundaba zethu zeChange Radio. Lamhlanje kumhla ka 4 kumfumfu 2024 indaba zifundwa nguntombi zodwa owakompofu izihloko zendaba ezigokelayo. Umongameli uJamisa ukhulume ngokuthuthukisa indawo zamabhizimisi. Gulotshintsho oluzaba khona kumthetho wokhetho njengoba inhlanganiso yeZEC ikhuthaza amaqembu ukuthi abhalise. UZulu lalabo abamela amalungelo abantu sebethukutheliswe yikubandlulula komthetho kucala likaThimba. Nanzi indaba ngokugcweleyo. Izolo umongameli uJamisa ukhulume ngenhlelo zokuthuthukisa indawo yokuthengisela izinto elizweni. Ukhulume ngokuqakatheka kobukhokheli obuqotho esithi izisebenzi kumele ziphile kuhle hathi ukudubeka. Usungule umbiko omutsha othi okwethu sonke hash for everyone. Ozaba yiwo ozaba ukhokhela inhlelo zentuthuko. Intathele izindaba yethu khokhelani hame ubexoxisana lomphathi kunhlanganiso yeCenter for Crypto Education umnumzana kunashe mutshemwa asizweni okunengi.
Clearly our country needs a new way of doing things and I'm happy that the former president of CCC Advocate Nelson Chamisa was speaking about plans being underway to improve the business environment. So he's talking to introduce a new way of doing things in terms of business, and that's exactly what we want. This country cannot progress if it's doing things the same old way. There are so many things that must be changed, and some of the key issues that must be looked into or that must be arrested are issues like inflation, for example, the workforce, people are working, the few that are still working, they are working and they are paid in worthless papers. They lack motivation because the money that they get paid with after going to work for a full month is worth nothing. And not just them alone. You go to the rural areas. Our parents there in the rural areas, they sell livestock and the money that they get is valueless. It can't buy anything. So inflation is one of the biggest enemies that we have. But of course, unemployment. There is no country that can develop if it's not creating jobs. And jobs can only be created when there's productivity in the country, when there's productivity in the businesses. So we definitely need a new way of doing things. But most importantly, corruption must be looked into. Whatever new way of doing things, it must make sure that it arrests corruption. We can't have a country cannot progress with such a high levels of corruption, especially in public service. I think the new laws that are much strict, that are harsh, must be introduced to make sure that anyone who is found to be corrupt as a public service must face a harsh sentence. So I think that it's important for that to be looked into, including looking into new ways of doing business that are brought by the fourth industrial revolution, look into the blockchain system, new technology, and find opportunities that are found there. So yeah, I actually welcome such words that I think are full of wisdom, and we just need to work together as a country and deposit our views that we have, and eventually we come up with the best model in terms of taking our country forward. Thank you.
Inhlanganiso ebona ngezokhetho kuleli yeZEC ikhuthaza amaqembu ukuthi abhalise okusemthethweni umnyaka wokhetho ka-2028 ungakafiki. Kule ngxaba ngxoza kulinhlanganiso kulandela udaba lomthetho we-Electoral Act. Asizweni intatheli izindaba yethu isinika okunengi.
Sekube lokusola ngemva inhlanganiso yeZimbabwe Electoral Commission iZEC sibizele ukuthi amaqembu abhalise okusemthethweni. Abanye bathi sokungenzeka amaqembu amadala athole inzuzo eningi kwedlula amaqembu amancane kumbe amatsha, kuphinde kuphazamise umncintiswano wezombusazwe.
So udlule amalanga alikhulu lachumi umhlonitshwa uthi imbala abanye yavonde u64 bebotshiwe bengakahlulelwa icala labo kusithi konke lokhu sokuthukuthelise abaningi kanye lamaqembu amela amalungelo abantu besithi konke lokhu akuhambisani lomthetho sisekelo asizweni okuningi ngalolu daba lamanye amacala enkantolo.
On this week's roundup of political and human rights activists' court appearances, iChange Radio's Kokilani Kame spoke to citizens' welfare bureau head, Mrs. Wongai Tome, who gave us this report.
A lovely evening to all citizens of Zimbabwe. We have the Welfare Bureau's weekly court digest this Friday, October 4, 2024. Zimbabwe's opposition leaders face repression, and today in the courts, we had Honorable Desim Gutsa of Marondera, Mashonaland East Province, Champion Phyllis Bigitai, wife to Teacher Ondongwa, Kudakwase Blackstone of Harare West, who appeared in court today and were remanded to 7 October 2024. That is on Monday. Meanwhile, Epworth Deputy Mayor Nobody Makoni has also been remanded in custody until the 9th of October for bail hearing. Honorable Kufa of Mabuku also appeared in court today and was further remanded to 18 October 2024. The arbitrary detention of Zimbabwean opposition leaders Jameson Timba and Amos Chibaya reflects the government's ongoing repression of dissent under a military dictatorship. Both leaders have faced legal challenges, including delays in their bail hearings, contributing to a broader climate of fear and repression within Zimbabwe's political landscape. Timba and 64 co-accused members of the supporters of Advocate Nelson Chamisa have spent weeks in pre-trial detention, alleging participation in peaceful protests and political activities. Amos Chibaya's bail hearing is scheduled for October 7, that is on Monday, and has drawn attention to the state's attempts to silence critics through intimidation and prolonged detention without fair trial processes. Citizens are encouraged to attend the upcoming bail hearing in solidarity with Honorable Chibaya, that is on Monday, 7 October, and also in solidarity with Senator J.Z. Timba and the Avondale 64 trial continuation. The government continues with its gross violations of human rights. A substantial peaceful show of support may pressure the judicial authorities to reconsider the charges against these leaders, promoting the notion that their detainment is unjust and politically motivated. The current regime is resorting to authoritarian tactics to maintain power. The military's pervasive influence over governance has created an atmosphere of impunity where dissent is systematically crushed. Supporting these leaders by attending the bail hearing on October 7th is vital for standing against the repression and advocating for a freer, fairer, democratic process in Zimbabwe. Free J.Z. Timba and the Avondale 64. Free Honorable Chibaya, the citizens' organizer. Free all political prisoners. Thank you.
Ipolisa elaphiwa umlando wokuphenya icala likamhlonitshwa uAmos Chibaya kutholakale ukuthi like laphatheka ekubopheni imhlonitshwa uPromise Mkhwananzi ngomnyaka odlulileyo. Kulandela ukuhlolisiswa kwezithombe uAdvocate Mike utshengise lo mfanekiso waleli polisa lizama ukumdonsa uMkhwananzi kodwa lisuke lakwala lokhu lisithi lalingekho kuleso sehlakalo. Isimo lesi sesilethe ukusolwa kokuqutshwa kwecala likamhlonitshwa uChibaya. Ukulandela indaba zethu ezisakazwe kumhlaka 25-30 Mpandula kanye lo 1 Mfumfu, iqembu leChange Radio livakatshelele izindawo ngemva kwalokho intatheli izindaba yethu uKhokhelani Hame uxoxisane lo kansila kaWard 4 uEdson Galulu asizweni ekhuluma.
Ndotenda kune mireporter wedu weChange Radio. Nokuya pa ground kuzoona mabasa atukuita pa ground through council ndofunga maona marodzi atagadzirisa kusagrave kugreda kuti marodzi anotenda muwodhi mangu aone kufambika. Ndofuka munoona tara yedu inofamba makomita omnibus makumba makombi yakaiswa tara zvakanaka ikaita mamarking sensophone kuratidza kuti basa tiri kuita kuti maresidents aone kuti munhu takavhotera kumira nesu kupusha kuti muwadhi medu munge mune madevelopments. Maonawo chisamba ground inova arena b stadium takagadzisa kusaroni tikaisa perimeter fence izvozvi makutambirwa mabhora vanhu vakuswera vachivaraidza entertainment muwadhi zvokuti vanhu vazhinji titokuvabvisa kubva kumadrugs kuti vaakuswera vachiona bhora muchisamba ground. Maonawo mapublic terrace edu takagadzira zvokuti amhando yepamusoro unopinda ukasununguka anga ashata adhirika mungoona kuti izvozvo mamiri akaita haa mega munongokusira kuti basa rikubatwa nemakadzori pagiraundi tichida kuti vanhu vedu vaone uremu hwakansera kuti takavhotera munhu arikwanisa kutimirira kukansero.
Asizweni okunenyi ngalolu daba.
Kulandela ukuvakatshela kweqembu le-Change Radio ku-1-3 lo-4 emtare sixoxisane labahlali basesakuva lasemtshena Old kanye lase-New Chisamba Mahonde lase-Odangari. Abahlali bafakaze ngendlela okhansela lomeli wale ndawo edale lephalamende abasebenza ngayo. Baphinde bancuma imisebenzi kamhlonitshwa uBrian James kanye lamakhansila kawadi 3 lo-4 uTichayenza Mayita kanye lo-Edson Galulu laba abasebenza ngokuzikhandla kuze indawo le iphumelele. Abanye abahlali belokhe behlala endaweni kakhansili babonge kakhulu ngemva kokuphiwa amaphepha aveza ukuthi sebengabanikazi bemizi. Njengeqembu le-Change Radio sitshengiswe imigwaqo elungisiweyo, indawo yokubhukutshela, inkundla engungqu kanye lezambuzi zikaZulu. Okhulumayo ngu-Elvis Kamathe, intatheli zindaba ye-Change Radio ngisemtare.
Emaphandleni elizweni bakhanyelane lodubo lokuswelakala kwamanzi kubangelwa yikuswelakala kwezulu i-El Nino. Kusithi iningi labantu lihamba umango onganye 500 meters ukuze bathole amanzi. Kusithi iningi lezikotsho seziwomile eMatabeleland South kanye lasemashingo. Lokhu kuchiya iningi labantu lisengozini yomkhuhlane ophathelane lesihudo. Inhlanganiso ye-UNICEF ikhuthaza ukuqakatheka kwamanzi ahlanzekileyo njalo ukuze le nkinga icubungulwe kudingakala imali engange $34 million. Kube lokukhombana ngeminwe ekhansilini yaseHarare kulandela ukuthengwa kwezimota eziphezulu ngabaphathi bakakhansili bekohlwa ukuqakathekisa impilo zabantu. Ubugwelegwele lokuphula umthetho yikho osokumemethekile kukhansili kuchiya inengi linganakwa. I-St. Wilfred's Medical Center inikela ngezempilakahle ezingakhokhelwayo eHarare Central Constituency eKambuzuma ngolwesihlanu ngo-11 Mfumfu. Ilunga lephalamende lesabelo seHarare umhlonitshwa uLove Mojimu ukhuthaza izakhamizi ukuthi besebenzise leli thuba besekele abezempilakahle esabelweni. Intatheli izindaba yethu Khokelani Hame ukhulumelaye wethulala mazwi.
Sekutanga ndinoda kuzivisai dzakangu dzinoitwa Honorable Jim veHarare Central. Ndiri kufara nechirongwa chiri kuitwa neSt. Wilfred's Medical Center chiri kuitwa muKambuzuma. Ndinokurudzira kuti vagari vese vemuHarare Central vane madambudziko ataurwapo zvinosanganisira maBP, shuga, mazino anorwadza chekwa kenza kuongororwa ropa wadini inonzi HIV test vane maproblemu emaziso vari kuti uyai muongororwe zviri pachena pasina mubhadharo pavari kuvhura medical center yavo iyo iri padhuze nepamashops pasection paisapo iyo iri muHarare Central. So vagari vese ndinokurudzirai kuti uyai uyai makasungunuka nouwandu hwenyu. Ndatenda hangu dini wenyu Honorable Jim.
Kumbiko wokukhumbula usuku lwe-World Teachers Day oqhutshwa mnyaka yonke ngo-5 Mfumfu, i-Amalgamated Rural Teachers Union of Zimbabwe ATUZ ibizele uhulumende ukuthi abanikeze umholo ozabancedisa ngendleko zabo. Intatheli izindaba yethu Khokelani Hame ukhulumelo ATUZ National President umnumzana Obet Masaraure ake simuzwe.
The Amalgamated Rural Teachers Union of Zimbabwe joins the rest of the world commemorating the World Teachers Day. The theme valuing teachers' voices towards the new social contract is a great theme. The theme really should force or at least compel the government of Zimbabwe to work on the basics and the fundamentals that can give the teachers the voice in the first place. Teachers can only have a voice when there is a right to collective bargaining. A fair wage, which we believe a fair wage currently, should be a minimum of 1,260. With that fair wage, they can be able to cater for the basics and can also have some savings, which is expected of any normal human being who is engaged in work, in decent work. But also, we're pushing for the right to strike, among other rights, which are already provided for in Section 65 of the Constitution. When the teachers have a voice, they can then add the voice to the national discourse with regards to the character of the pedagogy, with regards to the character of the curriculum. Then we can have the teachers' voice contributing effectively to building a new social contract for education. But that is not enough when the learners themselves can't make it to the classroom. So we believe the government has a responsibility, as is provided for in Section 75 of the Constitution of the Republic, to provide state-funded education for our children. We don't want to go to the classroom to teach children who are hungry, children who are struggling to pay school fees, among other things. So we want the state to provide for basic education. This has been now adopted, our process that we go to Namibia, we go to Botswana, even we go to Zambia. Most of our neighboring countries have adopted this system. We want the Zimbabwean government to provide state-funded education. We say it to teachers there, to all the teachers of Zimbabwe and teachers of the world.
Izolo ilanga libalele kujontshwe imali e-EcoBank kobulawayo. Umphakathi ukufakazile isehlakalo lesi ngathi yibhayisikopo. Amapolisa acabangela ukuthi isehlakalo lesi senziwe ngabasebenza lapho. Lokhu kwenzakala ngesikhathi abomthetho begijimisa abalwela ilungelo loluntu labeqembu eliphikisayo benganaki izigebengu. IZimbabwe Republic Police ZRPini Glens Province icela usizo lukaZulu ekubanjweni kwabesilisa abayisikhombisa abahlanganiswa lokubulawa kukaChrispin Lovu Siyamayiko emayini eRedcliffe eKwekwe ngombimbitho 2022. Umphakathi lemuli kamufi bafuna impendulo ngecala leli. Endabeni zezizweni, uJohn Hope Mutirahondo odabuka kwele Zimbabwe unodumo lokudlwengula eNew Zealand. Amapolisa abeqhuba uphendlo ngamacala ehlukeneyo okudlwengula. Kuthiwa wadlwengula oleminyaka elitshumi lasitshiyangalombili elele. Ngemva kokuthi avuke wananzelela ukudlwengulwa wasebaleka wahle wafonela amapolisa. lokhu kwabangela ukuthukuthela ku-lead investigator ngoba uMuchira Hondo engalandelanga umthetho. UDr. Mark Chavez wetheswa icala lokufa kuka-actor Matthew Perry okuhlanganiswa lama-drugs. Ulivumile icala eLos Angeles eCourt. Endabeni zemidlalo, iZimbabwe Under 20 National Team yehluleke ukungena kwa-AFCON U20 ngemva kokubhuqwa ku-penalty shootout bencintisana leZambia kuma-semi-finals e-COSAFA qualifier. Ama-Young Warriors adliwa 6-5 kuma-penalty ngemva kokuthi umdlalo uphele ku-2-2 stalemate. Ukuphetha lezi ndaba nanzi izihloko zendaba ezikhokhelayo. Umongameli uNelson Chamisa ukhulume ngokuthuthukisa indawo zamabhizinisi. Kulotshintsho oluza kuba khona kumthetho wokhetho njengoba inhlanganiso yeZEC ikhuthaza amaqembu ukuthi abhalise. UZulu lalabo abamela amalungelo abantu sebethukutheliswe ukubandlulula komthetho kucala likaThimba. Sesifike emaphetheleni yendaba zethu zeChange Radio. Igama nguNtombi Zodwa owakompofu kanye leqembu lonke leChange Radio sithi live lobusuku obuhle.